Hello everyone, welcome to MESS e-learning channel. In this lecture today, we'll study about what is a free body diagram. So free body diagram. This can be represented as FBD. So every problem in mechanics, that is every problem in mechanics which is there, is always assumed to be, actually every object is interacting with some other object which is available in our surrounding. So in order to solve all these problems or all this object, or if you want to analyze the forces in acting on the objects which are available around, so what we need to do is we need to isolate it from its initial environment, that is it is where it is right now. That is, if I want to study all the forces acting on my body, so what I need to do is I need to separate myself from the surrounding around me, that is the place where I am standing and everything. And then what I have to do is I have to see what are the forces which are acting on my body, that is the external forces acting on my body. And then we have to calculate this forces which are unknown in it. So for example, if I have a glass and I put a ball inside this glass, now what I need to do is I need to see what are the external forces, those are acting on this ball which is inside the glass. But when it is inside the glass, we can't actually see all the forces acting on it. So what we do, we take that ball out from its previous environment, we analyze now all the forces, all the external forces acting on this body. Now the external forces can be the active forces or can be the reactive forces. So now when we do this, that is we place all the active and reactive forces on this body, we get a diagram which is called as a FBD. So for example, let's say I have an object which is under rest at this position. Now this cylinder is kept on a surface. A simple example, if I want to draw its free body diagram, what I do is I'll isolate this from the given environment, that is on the surface where it is kept. So I draw the cylinder, and now the self weight of this cylinder will act downwards due to the its interaction with the gravitational force. So I have this weight force which will go downwards, and then as this is kept on a surface, the surface will also provide some reaction back to the ball in order to hold the cylinder in its own position. So there would be a reactive force too. Let's say that is a reaction to it. Let us take another example. So I have this, I have kept a cylinder here, and now I connect this with a string, and this surface is a vertical surface. Now in order to study all the forces in this cylinder, what I do, I separate it out from its current environment, I take it out and I draw all the external forces that I think are acting on this object. So this cylinder will have its own self weight, which will be acting downwards due to the gravitational force, let's say that is the weight. Next, what I'll have, this object is in contact with the vertical wall. So the wall, in order to balance it in that position, will provide a reaction force. So there will be a reaction force here. Now, there is a string which is connected from the center of the cylinder to this position. Now due to the string is attached on both the ends, there would be a tension in that string which would be acting as a external force to this cylinder. So I'll draw a tension force also. So these are all the forces, those are acting. Now if there is one force which is unknown, and we can calculate them. If there is one unknown force or two unknown force, whatever unknown forces we have, we can analyze and calculate them in order to know what are the actual amount of force that is acting on a object. Let us take another example where more than one bodies are interacting. So let's say I have this cylinder like this, two cylinder which are kept inside some trapezoidal surface. Now if I want to draw its free body diagram, what I do, I separate it from its current environment. So for this cylinder, let's say this is C1 and this is C2. For this cylinder, the current environment is this trapezoidal or whatever the surface is, and also this object is interacting with another cylinder. So I need to separate it out from both the things. So I draw my cylinder 1 here, and then I'll analyze all the forces acting on the cylinder 1 first, and then I'll separate out cylinder 2 also, and then analyze all the forces on cylinder 2 also. In this way, what happens is we will analyze all the forces on acting on both the cylinders and then calculate whatever is required. So let us draw the free body diagram for this. So here there will be some self weight of this object, so that self weight would be somewhere here. Let's say this is the self weight. This will be acting in the downward direction because there will be a gravitational pull. For this object also, there would be a self weight which will be acting downwards. Next, there is a surface here, and this surface is in contact with the cylinder 1, and this is at an angle. So if you see here, that reaction force is always perpendicular, as we know. So this would be the reaction that the surface will provide to the cylinder. So I'll draw the same reaction here. That would be, let's say, R1. Let's say this is my position 1, 2, 3, and 4. So this would be my R1. Now, also this cylinder is in contact with the horizontal surface. So there would be a reaction here, R2. Now, if you see, these two cylinders are in contact with each other. So in order to balance their own positions, they will provide each other an equal and opposite reaction. So I'll also draw this reaction here, because cylinder C2 will provide a reaction to cylinder 1, and cylinder 1 will provide the same amount of reaction to cylinder 2. So I'll draw that here also. That is R3. Now if this reaction is like this, for cylinder 2 it would be like this. So I would draw that same reaction R3 here. Next, there is this surface which is in contact with cylinder 2. So this would be the reaction force. So I'll draw that reaction force here. That is R4. So these are few examples of how we draw a free body diagram. Now free body diagram is not only restricted to this cylinder examples, but it can be drawn in any problem, any object. So this is how we draw a free body diagram. Hope you understood. Thank you.